In a world where longevity often means simply existing, the book Outlive by Dr. Peter Attia stands out as a beacon of hope, guiding you towards a future where every day is a gift, every moment is cherished, and every year is an adventure. It's not just about living longer, it's about living better. It's about embracing the principles of medicine 3.0, where the focus shifts from treating diseases to preventing them from ever happening. It's about personalized medicine that recognizes your unique needs and aspirations. Join us as we delve into the three pillars of longevity: physical health, mental well-being, and emotional balance. Please subscribe in order to stay tuned. Dr. Peter Attia is a Canadian-American physician known for his focus on the applied science of longevity, the extension of human life and people's overall health. He's also the host of a very popular podcast called The Peter Attia Drive. To achieve longevity, we must understand and confront the causes of slow death. Because if you don't live extremely, practicing extreme sports, for example, you can expect to die as a result of one of the chronic diseases of aging that the author calls the Four Horsemen: heart disease, cancer, neurodegenerative disease, or type 2 diabetes and related metabolic dysfunction. Longevity has two components. The first is how long you live. The second is how well you live, the period of life when we are free from disability or disease, which is called health span. Dr. Attia's goal is to create an actionable operating manual for the practice of longevity, a guide that will help you outlive, live longer and better. Longevity means that we should make efforts to prevent chronic diseases and improve our health span. And we should do it now rather than when disease has taken hold or when our cognitive and physical functions have already declined. He claims that this is not preventive medicine, it is proactive medicine. According to the author, there have been two distinct eras in medical history, and now we may be on the verge of a third. The first era, which he calls Medicine 1.0, was represented by Hippocrates and lasted almost 2,000 years after his death. Its conclusions were based on direct observation and supported guesswork. Hippocrates' major contribution was the vision that diseases are caused by nature and not by actions of the gods, as had previously been believed. Medicine 2.0 is transformational. It has eliminated deadly diseases such as polio and smallpox. Progress may have resulted entirely due to antibiotics and improved sanitation, but it has made little progress against the horsemen. It has been less successful against long-term diseases such as cancer. The author believes that we need a new way of thinking about chronic diseases, their treatment, and how to maintain long-term health. The goal of this new medicine, which he calls Medicine 3.0, is not to patch people up by removing their tumors and hoping for the best, but rather to prevent the tumors from appearing and spreading, to avoid that first heart attack, or to divert someone from the path to Alzheimer's disease. No patients are exactly alike. A treatment that works for one patient may be useless for the other. First, Medicine 3.0 puts much more emphasis on prevention than treatment. Second, it considers the patient as a unique individual. Medicine 2.0 treats everyone as basically the same, following the findings of the clinical trials that underline evidence-based medicine. The most important difference between Medicine 2.0 and Medicine 3.0 is that Medicine 3.0 demands more from you. As a patient, you must be well-informed, medically literate to a reasonable degree, and clear-eyed about your goals and risks. As the author explains, you are no longer a passenger on the ship, you are its captain. Medicine 2.0 focuses on helping us live longer with disease, but the focus of Medicine 3.0 is to live longer without disease. Peter Attia thinks that our strategy is to cope with the effects of aging. The author thinks about health span and its deterioration in terms of three categories, or vectors. The first is cognitive decline. The second is the decline and eventual loss of function of our physical body, We lose mass and strength, stamina, balance. The third has to do with our emotional health. Tactics are different too. Medicine 2.0 relies on two types of tactics: procedures, for example, surgery, and medications. Medicine 3.0 relies on five types: exercise, nutrition, sleep, emotional health, and exogenous molecules, drugs, hormones, or supplements. In Medicine 3.0, there are five tactical domains that we can use in order to improve our health. 1. Exercise. Peter Attia claims that it is the most powerful longevity drug. Exercise is so effective against diseases of aging, the horseman, that it has often been compared to medicine. It strengthens the heart and helps maintain the circulatory system. It prompts the body to produce its own endogenous drug-like chemicals. When we are exercising, our muscles generate molecules known as cytokines that send signals to other parts of our bodies, helping to strengthen our immune system and stimulate the growth of new muscle and stronger bones. Exercise such as running or cycling helps generate another molecule, BDNF, that improves the health and function of the hippocampus, a part of the brain that plays an essential role in memory. That's why he finds exercise an important part of the toolkit for patients at risk of developing Alzheimer's disease. In addition, muscle helps us live longer and survive old age. Regular exercisers live a decade longer than sedentary people. Having more muscle mass protects us from all kinds of injuries. 2. Diet or nutrition, or as he calls it, nutritional biochemistry. The author is associated with low-carb and ketogenic diets, but he is no longer a dogmatic advocate of any particular way of eating. He encourages his patients to avoid using the term diet at all. The molecules in the foods that we consume affect multiple enzymes and pathways and mechanisms in our bodies. Each of us will react to these food molecules in different ways. Instead of diet, we should be talking about nutritional biochemistry. It is not about telling you what to eat. It's about figuring out what works for your body and your goals. Nutrition is simple. There are a few basic rules. Don't eat too many calories or too few. Consume sufficient protein and essential fats. Obtain the vitamins and minerals you need. And avoid pathogens like E. coli and toxins like mercury or lead. Beyond that, we know relatively little with complete certainty. Dr. Attia's main rule for any eating pattern is that you must eat enough to maintain lean mass, muscle, and long-term activity patterns. 3. Sleep. Many studies have found connections between insufficient sleep and adverse health consequences, ranging from increased sensitivity to the common cold to dying of a heart attack. Sleep is the best medicine for our brain, our cognitive function, memory, and our emotional equilibrium. Dr. Attia claims that we need to sleep about 7.5 to 8.5 hours a night. Poor sleep wreaks havoc on our metabolism, but long sleep is also a sign of problems because it means poor quality of sleep. Poor sleep also changes the way we behave around food because when we sleep badly, we can be desperately hungry the next day. There is still no pharmacological magic bullet for sleep, but there are some effective things you can do to improve your ability to fall asleep and stay asleep. His recommendations are: don't drink any alcohol, don't eat anything less than 3 hours before bedtime, abstain from stimulating electronics 2 hours before bed, darken the room completely, spend time in a sauna or hot tub prior to bed, and fix your wake-up time. 4. Emotional health. The last chapter of the book, which the author considers the most important, is dedicated to emotional health. It represents the most significant component of our health span. Misery and unhappiness can destroy your physical health like other diseases. Nothing about longevity is worth it without some degree of happiness, fulfillment, and connection to others. None of it matters if your wife hates you, or if you're a bad father, or if you are consumed by anger or addiction. He thinks that the most important ingredient in our striving for longevity is the why. Why do we want to live longer? What for? Who for? The journey to outlive should have clarity, purpose, and meaning. Staying young, even as we grow older, is when we think more about our dreams and future and not about the past. Thank you for watching. If you're interested in the topic of longevity, we have a whole playlist of book summaries on that. Please check it out.